My first interest in science was memory, because memory really defines who we are as people. But when I thought about memory, I realized that the things that really stick with us, the things that persist, are the emotional things, the things that matter. And that led me into studying how things come to matter to us. So, and that took me to emotional learning. In my research, I hope to be able to take advantage of all the knowledge we've learned about how the brain functions from research in other species and apply that to humans so that we can develop new ways to treat a range of psychopathologies, including PTSD, addiction, and so on. When we look at the human brain, and when you're afraid, we see the amygdala is involved, and we've known this from research in other species as well. But when we try to now see how it is changed when you try to control a fear, either through new experiences or perhaps through using your thoughts to think about things differently, or even trying to target stages of the learning process so you can change a memory completely forever, we see involvement of other regions as well, such as the prefrontal cortex. And what we know about the prefrontal cortex is it's a brain region that gets somewhat impaired when you're stressed. So this makes it harder to control the fear. So we try to find ways in which we can alter fear without involving the prefrontal cortex so that now we can permanently get rid of fears as opposed to simply inhibiting them. And looking at the brain, we can look at those circuits and see where they go wrong in PTSD and then try to target those brain systems.